Oh no, I switched covenants so my swarm is on. actually gonna open on the soul binder just for the stun. Why is Guardian does not get stunned? Had the volley go off. Okay, we recover. I maybe survive. I don't survive. I should have just health potted there and canceled my cast. Yeah, so I survive if I health pot next turn. I don't know why I ripped that, I guess because it's just gonna insta-die. Unlucky waste of combo points. Soulbinder again.
Your souls are mine to claim. Let your fears consume you.
Wither in my grasp. Age altered so I can do damage and just let his altar heal him back up to full. It's a little bit early, but that's okay. Refresh our dots really quick, and then we'll go back to heal. Actually, we need to heal because we have the ear buff. Kidding. Spell Shaman here. Not have very many defensives up. Spell Warrior myself. Here because this is the nasty overlap where we get the debuffs right after this. Spell Mage. Warrior. Tank.
I will rip your soul from your body.
Yeah, Spell Mage. Ironbark in the tank again. Gonna get another use of it. General thoughts on the tank. Let me go back to the image. Use my Heart of the Wild here. Back up for the boss since we have the CDR. He just used the tank buster, so he's not going to use it again before he dies, so I'm not even going to soothe him. We just kill him before he uses it again.
Glory will be mine.
You going to bear for him? Put a wild growth and a flow down. Be enough to carry us through. Interrupting shouts. And then I'll soothe if he does another interrupting shout, which he probably will right here. Oh my gosh, I keep shape shifting while I'm pressing my push attack. Yeah, so we soothe that. Throw another wild growth out. Get stealth for the pack, and I'm gonna hit one of the arbalest. Stun. How much damage we're taking. Get some initial hots out on one of the arbalists, and then dots, I should say, and then we'll put a lot of healing into the group here. Things go south very fast. Press my bark skin. Trying to refresh dots on the arbalist. Not really worried about any other mobs. We dot them up. Trank. Soothe this arbalist. Easy peasy. Got the flying one on axe.
Your bones will adorn my armor.
Same thing, because it's tyrannical, I should just be able to keep F flow and wild growth going, and that would be enough. Oh no. Can't line of sight that. Be ready to line of sight this time. Adding. We have the healing buff right now, so I'm not even gonna do any healing. I'm gonna soothe this before. Oh, not gonna get it again. I'm so bad. And then. Okay, it's just a warm-up. Okay, so here just the mage needs to be picked up. The other two got sent down, they'll be full HP when they come back. Healing, this boss is gonna be dead.
That was a good fight.
Gonna vortex up with all the jumpy guys. Put some healing out. I'm gonna focus my damage into the butcher here. These guys before they jump. It's a little bit too late, but that's. Thing here, we just focus our damage into the butcher mostly. Go activate our friends down here, press move. Oh, he's casting it from down there, that's very unlucky. Let me just line inside it. Sometimes he jumps first up here. And sometimes you're unlucky and he just starts casting down there, so like a range has to kick him. Like technically I could save, like I could stay in cat form and maim him if he casts down there, but either way it's kind of awkward, so. Just unlucky, so we just use the hill to line of sight it. It only hit two people, so it's not that big of a deal. This guy. Same thing, because it's a lower key and it's tyrannical. I should be good to just like keep F flow down and keep pressing wild growth when it comes up. And other than that, I can just like do damage the entire time. Should be plenty of healing. Let me soothe here. Wild growth again. We're just back to doing damage. Yeah, I'm just gonna dot them both up. Uh-oh. That's not good. Ironbark tank here. It's not using defensive for that. Hateful Strike. The passive healing here. Just do damage. And a vortex here in case they jump in a range. Their one tried to jump on the mage. His group damage just a little bit by canceling some of the jumps. So we need to do some healing. Warrior removed his debuff. In trouble. Good timing on that Celestial Brew though. You get some more damage, refresh dot. Gonna press my bark skin here in case they keep jumping on me. Iron bark the tank. Healing again. A lot of trouble right now. And then regrowth. I don't need to use the Beerus. Alright, cool. And then the mage gets a shortcut, so with RP. Then we two chests, easy. I don't think I showed it at the start. Obviously, you can see all my equipped stuff up at the top left, but here's like a. While we're running to the next boss, here's my gear setup and talents and whatnot. Just running a low eye level version of the Draught of Deep Focus. Once I get some Cosmic Flux, I'm gonna make the actual 291 version. This is before Double Legendaries. The week before, actually. Alright, here we go. Bark skin and iron bark tank here. Wild growth. And again, that wild growth and F-flow should be plenty to like top us back off after that little bit of damage that the group took. Main concern is just keeping the tank nice and healthy for each of the sides. And then here, same thing again, we have that F-flow down, we press Wild Growth, and then we should be good to just keep doing damage. It'll pick us back up.
My magic reaches beyond your mortal wanton slaughter will be returned tenfold.
Throw Wild Growth and a couple rejuves out just to get us topped off a little bit quicker. There, I should have full healed the tank, but we trusted.
My magic reaches beyond.
Some hots on the tank in this last phase. It's really important to actually keep the tank like fully hotted up. There's just a lot of stuff that can kind of randomly one-shot. Spark skin here. We can trank here because people are taking a lot of damage. Ironbark. Boss should be dead. Just wild growth, just in case. There you go. Chest. Plenty of time to spare. That's like a two chested 17 almost. Nice.